So whether through referral or not, but definitely through word of mouth, we're getting people in the door. Our gym's set, our equipment's there, all of the logistics are taken care of, and now we've got new clients. The job is to make them CrossFitters. And a lot of us do that through an on-ramp program that is a specific curriculum dedicated toward making them a member of your gym. Jason, Ben, Rick, you guys all have a very structured program, and we're going to talk about your curriculums in a minute. But Amy, you and Chris here at Southie have kind of eschewed, said, we're not going to have that specific on-ramp. In fact, your clients, your new clients, learn simultaneously with classes. How does that work, and how did you come to the conclusion that you weren't going to have a dedicated on-ramp?
It wasn't on purpose at all. When we first started, we realized to have an on-ramp program with all new members, it was kind of silly only because everyone was still learning. So pretty much every class was like an on-ramp class. It was like every day we went over everything in depth, and it was very well structured. So what we did instead is that we did the intro session. We made our intro sessions very much in depth. So they come in, so new members, they'll come in, they have to set up an appointment in advance so that we have an extra coach here. So we have a coach teaching the class and a coach here for the intro sessions. So the coach that is here for the intro session will kind of sit back while their new member, potential new member, is going through the warm-up and everything with the class. So then right off the bat, they have an idea of what a warm-up of a class entails, because our warm-ups are about 15 to 20 minutes. So it's almost like a workout in itself. So we want people to understand that, you know, it is like an hour-long commitment from start to finish. So then as soon as we're done with that warm-up, the coach will take them over the side and we actually go over the 9 fundamental movements with a PVC pipe in depth. We teach them how to squat, we put our hands on them, we make sure that they are moving correctly from the very beginning, from the minute they walk in the door. So what this does is this eliminates, for people, they come in and they think CrossFit, they're like, oh, it's a boot camp, it's, you know, it's this and that, it's like P90X, it's like all these other things that they try to compare it to, where it's nothing, it's like nothing they've ever done before. So when they come in and they're doing these intro sessions that has like the 9 fundamental movements in it, they're learning how to move with potentially this a barbell, I mean, they're gonna understand that there's a learning component. It's like there's a lot of, you know, it takes a lot of time. They're not gonna just come in and be, you know, just number one in the class. You know, they're seeing, like, they're going through all this whole learning process in, you know, a very short period of time. So once we get through the fundamental movements, we teach them the box jump and we teach them the thruster and the burpee. We do a 7-minute AMRAP, 5 thrusters, 5 burpees, 5 box jumps. People are dead by the end of their 7-minute AMRAP, but at least it's an AMRAP. So if you have 4 people in an intro, or if you have 1 person in an intro, it won't really matter.
Why not 7 rounds for time?
Because if you have a group of 4 people, 5 people, and 1 person does really well, the other person does very poorly, then they're gonna leave with a negative first impression. So at least with the AMRAP, they don't feel the pressure of having to finish something. It's over in 7 minutes, no matter what. And for time constraints and everything as well. I mean, it just fits better into the hour than trying to do a 3 rounds for time or 5 rounds for time or 7 rounds for time.
Gentlemen, and Ben, I want to ask you specifically, what does your on-ramp curriculum look like?
We've been through a number of different variations of our Elements program. Right now, the way we're doing it is it's all one-on-one coaching. What we found is that first, it works better for clients' time constraints. They're gonna be, you know, so many people were coming out of the class and doing the one-on-one sessions anyway. This way, they get to it on their schedule. The second is, what we were first and foremost concerned with was getting our members up to speed so that they could come into the classes and feel comfortable with what was going on. And with the one-on-one setting, we had a lot more control over that. We were actually dealing with one person's issue and we could deal with them specifically. We go so far as to finding out what their movement constraints are, and we send them home with like mobility work to do, and then they do that mobility work before every single class. So that they're not just coming in and being like, here is a squat, here is a press. They're getting like it tailored to them specifically. Our program is a 4-day program, one-on-one sessions. where it's tailored very closely to what a level one would look like, where the day one is the squat series, day two is the presses series, day three is the deadlift series, and then day four is a learning the clean and reviewing the push jerk. Each day concludes with a 15-minute talk, just like very abbreviated talks like they do in the level one. We do what is fitness on the first day, or vice versa, what is CrossFit, what is fitness and nutrition on the third day. Fourth day is left to kind of like hash out any questions the person might have and make sure that they're completely comfortable with what's going on in the next step.
And you've found that this format is the one that gets people in their first class ready to go.
It gives us the biggest retention rate. It's the one that definitely gives the client the most success. It has stemmed our growth, which we're okay with at this point. We don't have much room for more people anyway. So that might be another side reason why we did this. It's not going to ramp up your business as fast as doing the class setting, where you're getting 8 to 12 people at a pop in through the Elements class. This is one at a time, and we usually have on a given week maybe like 3 or 4 people going through it, as opposed to when we were doing before, we'd have upwards of, you know, 10 to 15 people per week going through it. We don't have room for that growth anyway, so we thought that why bother with it when we give someone a better product?
And Jay, you do a 4-day format as well.
6-day.
You do a 6-day. Okay, I'm sorry. But you do not do that in a one-on-one scenario, or you do?
No, our 6-day on-ramp is in a group setting. It starts every Monday because we alternate time. So one Monday will start at 5 p.m. and then it runs concurrently with the next Monday starting at 7 p.m. So we always have 2 on-ramps going on, and they run for 2 weeks on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. When we had first opened, we started with just like Amy, kind of come in, we throw you into the wolves, like, hey, we're doing Fran, this is what you're doing, good luck. That worked for a little while. Then we did a 3-day Elements, much like Ben's, that was one-on-one based on your time constraints and when we can work with you. And now we just found we were filling up our schedule every day. And I was hesitant going to a 6-day on-ramp where there was certain days and times that it started, but it's been very successful, and it's allowed our members to come into class much more educated, much better with the movements, and feeling a lot more confident. Because of our layout, they're able to come in at the same time class is running, so they get to see what's going on in class, they get to mingle with the athletes that are taking class, but then they go into their own space where they feel a little safer.
The commonalities between these approaches, it's clear, it's instant education. And of course, part of the education of being a CrossFitter is exactly what it feels like to throw down when 3-2-1 go happens. Amy, do you think on my first day of CrossFit that I should do a WOD, do a workout of the day?
I think so. I mean, just at least that's how what we do here. I mean, we have that one-on-one intro session. So they start with the warm-up, we go over the fundamentals, and then we give them that workout, because you really want people to understand like what they're signing up for, and it's, you know, for us too as coaches, you don't want to spend a lot of time coaching somebody that is going to drop off in like 1 month, or drop off right away, or, you know, or is going to talk badly about, you know, your business once they're part of the community, because it's not what they were looking for. So you just want to make sure that, I mean, this WOD, this short WOD, I mean, you know, you can make it. You can scale it down. They can use a PVC pipe for the thrusters. They can use a 12-inch box for box jumps. You can make it as simple as possible, but you want to have people to understand that they're here to work hard and that we're not going to sympathize with them if they don't want to. That this is, I mean, I go as far as to no rep people. I know they call me, like, I can be really tough on the first day, but it's, you want people to understand that, like, you're in here to do things right, you're in here to move right, you're in here to learn. Like, it's not going to be just like throw the barbell around and you can do whatever you want, because it's about having fun, but it's also about, you know, adhering to movement standards, and it's about being fair across the board for everyone. Everyone should have to do everything the same way so that it's fair.
Ben, in your response to the on-ramp questions and the idea of that first aid dose, your on-ramp program is very biased towards cognitive education. What is it that you need to know to do this? And the dose is relatively small. maybe for a conditioned athlete, not terribly painful. Can you tell me about the first WOD that folks do at CrossFit New England and why you've chosen to do that?
Sure. It's actually, so this is the first WOD that we do during the Elements course. So their first exposure to CrossFit is very minimal in terms of the intensity. And the reason for that is anybody that's been through a level one knows what just going through the movements is like with a PVC pipe, and we're all conditioned athletes. People leave those things sore, and it's not necessarily because of Fran, it's because of all the up and downs and hold the bottom of the squat, which is what we do during our Elements class. We spend a lot of time and a lot of emphasis on the coaching side of it, and we don't see that the benefit in a one-on-one setting of doing a WOD is going to outweigh that time that could be spent coaching, getting them moving better. Having said that, when we did the Elements course and it was a class setting, we did do WODs in that atmosphere because it is worthwhile and you get the camaraderie and stuff. And one of the best things that we did in that setting was day one, we did a team workout. And day one team workout, they really see the bonding. Then all of a sudden it really breaks the ice and it really gets the people moving, you know, rooting on each other. And they see like that side of CrossFit, which is what we're trying to, if we were to expose them to anything, we want to expose them to that. More so than like, this is hard, this is painful, this is tough. Like, they're gonna get that. They, you know, if they see that this is a supportive community, that generates even more, likability for CrossFit, for such a bad word.
Jay, do you incorporate nutrition education into your on-ramp program? Do they see that immediately?
Absolutely. We do that on day two, and it's really important because, as we all know, nutrition is vital, and it's important for most of our athletes in reaching their goals. So it's important that they understand CrossFit and also how to fuel their body to do well at CrossFit.
And Ben, I've seen some of your trainers doing the same. There's definitely a nutrition education component.
Yeah, our nutrition component is a pared-down version of what they do at the level one. We talk about, it's more on the paleo side than the zone side, because I think it's more easy to understand. But nutrition is a huge component of what we do at CrossFit New England, and we try and get it set the bar right away with that first Elements program.
I asked all of you if you use level one material in your intro classes, and universally you all said yes. Amy, what is the utility in your mind of using pieces of that curriculum?
I mean, it's just basically the reason why we have level ones is because it's the most efficient way to teach the movements, and the way that it's broken down is just, going from the most fundamental into the more complex movements. And, I just think that when you see that information, when you place that in front of people, even if they don't quite understand it at first, over time, like the first time, like learning something for the second time is so much easier than learning it for the first time. So. Just implementing like the very like details of each movement the first time that they come in really just helps, I think, how they pay attention and how they learn things like over the course of their time in classes.
Once people are through your intro class, it's been done in whatever curriculum you choose, you've introed them, you've gotten them ready for it to be a part of your general population, how do you actually introduce them to classes? Ben, you guys use a welcome packet. What is that?
Once they're done with their Elements program, we send them an email, and the email is basically a welcome to CrossFit. Here's what to expect, and here's what we expect of you, and here's how you should proceed going forward. So it's everything from signing up to what to expect in terms of scaling workouts specific to that person. And it also tells them about the other services that we provide, CrossFit Kids or personal training or whatever it may be, specialty classes. It gives them a schedule. It's basically a little pamphlet or lays out everything that has to do with CrossFit or CrossFit New England, and then lays it out specifically for them and how they should kind of proceed in those first. We laid out basically for the first probably 3 months of CrossFit in three or four different stages.
And what do you find that gives them? Are you looking to just give them a sense of ease? Is it?
We're hoping to let them know that the education doesn't stop with the Elements course. You know, this is going to be a continued process that goes on forever. Second is, before they even step foot in their first class, they can expect a little bit more of what's going on, that we're going to scale your workouts. It's not an option for them, it's what happens. You know, whether you're grandma coming off the couch or you're a Navy SEAL or ex-football player, this is what we see for you. And it's not like a prescription for everybody, it's laid out for them. You know, a coach actually writes it up. Here's what you're going to be doing when you come in. You're going to scale it this way. You can talk to the coach beforehand and they'll confirm it with you.
And Jay, you actually make a bit more of a ceremony of leaving the on-ramp process, of getting into that general population. You talk about literally bringing your intro folks into the other room, the other court, where that simultaneous class is happening. What happens there? Tell me about that scene.
It becomes just a lot of fun. You know, we actually bring the class into the on-ramp as they finish their last workout, and then have everybody cheer them on, and it's kind of like an induction ceremony, and they get all excited and they push themselves harder, and then they get a much better feel of what it's like to be a part of the team and a part of the group, as you know, they're pushing and people are yelling their names and encouraging them to do better. And it gives them an understanding of what classes will be like, because if you're not used to it and you haven't seen it yet, having somebody yell at you while you're doing a workout may not be something you think is cool. But for most CrossFitters, we enjoy that and it helps us perform better.